Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another segment of the Trader's Edge. Today, we're going to talk about hedging FANG exposure or technology exposure using micro E-mini futures. So let's just say you're an investor and you've seen large gains in your tech portfolio, and you're kind of afraid of the experience that happened in the fourth quarter repeating itself. You have some really great gains in the FANG stocks, Facebook, Amazon, Netflix, and Google, and you're worried about a decline in the market. So there's a way you can hedge against a decline in the market using the micro E-mini futures contracts or the regular E-mini Nasdaq futures contracts. So let's say an investor's got a tech portfolio of holdings in FANG stocks, all right? Let's say in addition, the investor's approaching long-term holding period. He wants to be able to hold the portfolio a little bit longer so he gets long-term capital gains treatment and not pay higher taxes by selling before their time, so to speak. So selling before the holding period would be a taxable event. It's a taxable event no matter what, but if you have a long-term holding, it's a better tax situation. So the client portfolio consists of roughly $38,000 in Facebook, $38,000 in Amazon, and $38,000 in Netflix and Google each. Total value of the portfolio, about $152,000, all right? So, calculating the hedge. So, with a portfolio value of $152,000, an investor could choose to hedge with one E-mini NASDAQ 100 futures, or they could hedge using 10 micro E-mini NASDAQ futures, as they have achieved good liquidity in their first few months of trading. They've done very well. It's one of the most successful futures contracts launch in the history of all futures contracts. So, there's good liquidity, there's a lot of market makers, and there should be no problem implementing this hedge. So given that the FANG stocks make up 30% of the NASDAQ 100 index, the investor believes this hedge, although affected, might introduce some tracking error. Remember, you're only covering 30% of the NASDAQ 100. They're big stocks, there's four of them, but there's still 70% of the other components of the index too. That will also be exacerbated because the beta, or the sensitivity of these four stocks relative to its benchmark, is a lot more. As a matter of fact, the betas indicate they're about 40% more volatile than the market overall. As a result, the investor has to consider selling not only 10 futures in the micro E-minis, but he might want to, you know, think about doing a little bit more. And we'll talk about that in a second, the next slide. So not all portfolios correlate perfectly with an index. If you have a portfolio of just four stocks, there might be some tracking error with the NASDAQ 100. Even if you had a portfolio of 20 stocks in the NASDAQ 100, it might not correlate perfectly. So given the large beta values in the FANG stocks, it's entirely possible that if the market were to have a 10% correction, the FANG stocks might actually drop more than 10%, causing an imperfect hedge, or what is known as tracking error. So a partial solution, a possible solution, investor can sell additional micro E-mini NASDAQ futures, more than 10 of them, to adjust for the increased volatility. So if they're 40% more volatile, and the investor would consider selling additional futures contracts to offset this higher volatility, instead of doing 10 contracts, they would sell 14 contracts, or 40% more. And that would make up for the additional volatility in the FANG stocks. Again, this would require a little bit of math, a little calculation, and you'd have to look up the betas of the stocks too. So, and you'd have to beta weight and beta average this thing too. So it gets a little bit tricky, but it's not that difficult at all. So how does it look as a little summary? I have here average daily volumes of the FANG stocks, the QQQs, and also the E-mini NASDAQ 100 futures and the micro E-mini NASDAQ futures. And you can see there a portfolio of 198 shares of Facebook would be about $38,000, 22 shares of Amazon, 102 shares of Netflix, and 34 shares of Google. That's essentially the portfolio we talked about on the prior page. And we have the notional value of about $151,000, $152,000, and the amount that it would cost you would use to hedge. The notional value of the mini NASDAQ is $7,600. The notional value of the micro E-mini NASDAQ 100 is $760. And you can see all the advantages there. 24-hour trading, 60-40 tax treatment using the micro E-mini futures and the E-mini futures. And they're just a superior investment for hedging. So, but you, I want to impart to everyone, always do your homework, especially when it comes to hedging, hedge ratios and betas and things like that. So good trading to everyone out there.